today we are going to perform the experiment number 2, that is granulation compression and evaluation of soluble aspirin tablet IP, that is Indian Pharmacopoeia. See here we can prepare soluble aspirin tablet, okay, that is the soluble tablet we have to prepare. In last experiment we have to prepare the paracetamol tablet, okay. So but for preparation of tablets we can use the three methods. For preparation of tablet we can prepare the granules, okay, or we have to use the direct powder or API as a direct compression, okay. So here for preparation of tablet we can use either one of the method. In that total three methods is present: direct compression, dry granulation and wet granulation, okay. So in direct compression here we can use the directly powder sample, excipients and API, okay, and directly we can compress in tablet machine. Then second is the dry granulation. In dry granulation here we can prepare the granules without addition of liquid solution, okay. Why we cannot add here a liquid solution? Because some products are sensitive to moisture and heat, so we cannot add any liquid in that formulation, okay. Then next is the wet granulation. In wet granulation here we can prepare the granules by addition of liquid solutions. So in last experiment we can prepare the paracetamol tablet, and in that paracetamol tablet we have to add the starch paste as a liquid solution, and that starch paste is used as a binder, okay. But in today's experiment we can prepare the soluble aspirin tablet, and here we can use the 5% PVP in alcohol. 5% PVP in alcohol means that is 5% polyvinyl pyrimidone in ethanol, okay. This PVP in alcohol is used as a binder, okay. So here also in today's experiment we can use the wet granulation method. In last experiment in paracetamol tablets we can use the wet granulation because starch paste it is a liquid solution. So that in paracetamol tablet we can use the wet granulation method, and here for preparation of aspirin tablets here also we can use the wet granulation method. So then here we can prepare the soluble aspirin tablet. So what is the soluble tablets? See here, soluble tablets, the tablet is dispersed in spoonful solution. If we can add the tablet in any spoonful solution, that tablet is fastly dissolved. It means the tablet is disintegrated fastly, okay. Why the tablet is disintegrated fastly? Because in that tablet formulation we can add the disintegrants, okay. So in aspirin tablets here we can add the disintegrants, that is starch. Then this soluble aspirin tablet is easy to swallow, okay. They are easy to swallow and they dissolve very fastly. Within a fraction of second or within a 10 or 15 minutes this soluble aspirin tablet is dissolved in the stomach. Then next formula for preparation of soluble aspirin tablets. See here in this chart, here we can use the ingredients. First aspirin, second lactose, third 5% PVP in alcohol, then fourth starch 5%, and fifth sodium benzoate 1%. See here we can use the aspirin. This is the main API, okay. API that is the active pharmaceutical ingredient, and the category of the aspirin is analgesic. Then lactose we can use as a diluent. Then 5% PVP in alcohol, this is used as a binder, okay, in formulation of tablet. Then starch we can use in 5%. The use of the starch is disintegrants. Then last is the sodium benzoate 1%. This is used as a lubricants. Lubricants means which improve the flow property, okay, of the powder sample or granules. So see here we can use the aspirin for one tablet 300 mg, lactose for one tablet 40 mg, 5% PVP in alcohol for one tablet quantity sufficient, starch 5% and sodium benzoate 1%, okay. Okay, then we can convert this milligram into the gram. See here, aspirin is the 300 mg. So 300 mg converts into the gram, 0.3 gram. Okay, and then this second column we can prepare the quantity for 20 tablets. So this 0.3 gram multiplied with 20, okay? Because here we can take the weight for 20 tablets. 0.3 multiplied with 20 is equals to 6 gram, okay? This quantity for one tablet and this quantity for 20 tablets. Then second is the lactose, 40 milligram. We can convert 40 milligram into the gram, 0.04 gram, okay? Then we can multiply with 20. The value is 0.8 gram. Then 5% PVP in alcohol, it is required quantity sufficient, okay? Then starch, 5%, okay? So we can convert this 5% into the grams. See here, we can first add this 6 and 0.8 gram. 6 and 0.8 gram, that is aspirin and lactose. The addition is 6.8 gram. So this 6.8 gram is the 100%. So we have to require starch 5%. So how much gram starch is required in 5%, okay? Then again cross multiply, 5 multiplied with 6.8 divided by 100. So x is equal to 0.34 gram. So 0.34 gram starch is required for 20 tablets. I can write here 0.34 gram starch, okay? The last ingredient is the sodium benzoate. This is the lubricant we can add at the last of the experiment. So, how to prepare a 5% PVP in alcohol? See here, 5% PVP in alcohol means we can add 0.5 gram polyvinyl pyrimidone in 5 ml ethanol. Okay, PVP means polyvinyl pyrimidone. This 0.5 gram we can add in 5 ml ethanol. See here, we can prepare the 5% PVP in ethanol. This is the ethanol. We can take 5 ml ethanol by using measuring cylinder. Okay. See here, 5 ml ethanol we can add in beaker. In 5 ml ethanol, we have to add slowly polyvinyl pyrimidone. 0.5 gram PVP we can add in ethanol. Then for preparation of granules, we can take all ingredient in water and pestle. First we can take aspirin 6 gram, triturate in one direction, mix properly, then add second ingredient lactose 0.8 gram, lactose is used as a diluent. Mix properly. Then add third ingredient starch 0.34 gram. And triturate uniformly in one direction. After mixing is completed, then add slowly binder, that is 5% PVP in ethanol, and prepare a damp mass. See here, we can add slowly ethanol and prepare damp mass. See here, after addition of PVP in ethanol as a binder, we can prepare a damp mass. This damp mass we can pass through sieve number 10 for preparation of granules. See here, this is the sieve number 10. We can pass this damp mass through this sieve number 10
for preparation of granules. See here, this is the granules. After preparation of granules, then these granules we can pass from sieve number 22 and 44. Below sieve is the 44 and above sieve is the 22. Okay. See here, we can pass slowly, slowly these granules from sieves. Here, after passing the granules from sieve number 22, the granules is retained on the sieve number 44. The granules is retained on the sieve number 44. This is the granules, and we can weight. We have to take the weight of the granules. Okay, and the below is the fines. This is the fines we can add in these granules to complete or to fill the void space or porosity. See here, we can take the weight of granules. First, tear the filter paper. Then, place slowly, slowly granules. The weight of the aspirin granules is 5.04 gram. Note down it. Then, take the weight of fines. Note down this weight, 1.10 gram. Then we can take the weight of remaining PVP in alcohol for determination of how much PVP we can use in granulations. See here, this weight is 32.68. Okay, this weight we can call as the PVP in ethanol with beaker weight. That is 32.68 gram. After preparation of granules, we can calculate the theoretical yield and practical yield. Okay, so see here, how we can calculate the theoretical yield. For calculation of theoretical yield, we can add all intragranular components, that is aspirin, lactose, PVP and starch. Okay, so aspirin is the 6 gram, then lactose is 0.8 gram, the addition is 6.8. Then in that 6.8 we can add the starch quantity, that is 0.34. Here we can determine the starch quantity and then we can add in the 6.8. Total is the 7.14. The remaining quantity is only the 5% PVP in alcohol. So how we can calculate the how much PVP we can use in the granulation. So see here, we can determine the remaining weight of the PVP with beaker. This is the remaining PVP in ethanol weight with beaker weight, that is 32.68. So empty beaker weight is 29.14. We can minus this total weight minus empty beaker weight. The remaining weight is 3.54 ml. Means 3.54 ml is the remaining weight of PVP in ethanol. So we can prepare the 5 ml PVP in ethanol, then we can minus 3.54 ml PVP in ethanol. So the remaining quantity is 1.46 ml. It means 1.46 ml PVP in ethanol we can use in the granulation process. So this 5 ml PVP contains 0.5 gram. 5 ml PVP in ethanol solution contains 0.5 gram polyvinyl pyrrolidone or PVP. So 1.46 ml, how much PVP contains? We can cross multiply. 1.46 multiplied with 0.5 gram divided by 5 ml is equals to 0.146 gram. It means in 1.46 ml solution, 0.146 gram PVP is present. In 5 ml solution, 0.5 gram PVP is present. And in 1.46 ml, 0.146 gram PVP is present. So that weight we can note down here. See here, in one tablet, 5 ml PVP solution is present and it contains 0.5 grams. Okay. But here we can actually use 1.46 ml and it contains 0.146 gram PVP. Then this 0.146 also we can add in this value. Then the total value is 7.286 gram. This value we can call as the theoretical yield. In this theoretical yield we can add starch, then we can add PVP in alcohol, then lactose and aspirin. So this 4 is called as the intragranular component and we can add this all value here. Then this is called as the theoretical yield. Then next is the, we can determine the practical yield. See here, for determination of practical yield, we can take the granule weight. Granule weight is 5.08 gram. Then final weight is 1.10 gram. Practical yield is equals to the granule on mesh plus 10% fine. So granule on mesh weight is 5.08 gram plus 10% fine we have to add. The total fine is 1.10 gram. This is the 100% fine. So we have to require only 10% fine. Then how much fines is used in gram for 10%? Then cross multiply. The result is 0.11 gram fines is required in granules. Okay. So we can add this 0.11 in this granule weight. So total weight is 5.08 gram plus 0.11 is equals to 5.19 gram. This is called as the practical yield, 5.19 gram. Here the theoretical yield is present and here the practical yield is present. Then we can add both. That is called as the percent yield. Percent yield is equals to practical yield upon theoretical yield multiplied with 100. So practical yield is 5.19, theoretical yield is 7.286 multiplied with 100. The percent yield is 71.23%. Okay, so finally the percent yield is 71.23%. Then next step, we can determine the individual tablet weight. For preparation of one tablet, how much aspirin quantity is required or how much aspirin granules is required. So for preparation of individual tablet weight, we can take, firstly we can determine the 20 tablets. For 20 tablets, we have to use 7.286 gram ingredients. And in that 7.286 theoretical yield contains 6 gram aspirin, okay? This is the theoretical yield, okay? In that theoretical yield, 6 gram aspirin is present, okay? This below is the 5.19 gram practical yield. So how much aspirin is present in this practical yield, okay? Theoretical yield contains 6 gram aspirin. Then practical yield contains how much aspirin? Again cross multiply, the x is equals to 4.27 gram. It means in practical yield, 4.27 gram aspirin is required. Then for one tablets, this is for 20 tablets. This 6 gram aspirin is required for 20 tablets. And here also the 4.27 gram aspirin is required for 20 tablets. Then for one tablet, 5.90, that is practical yield contains 4.27 gram aspirin, okay? Then 0.3 gram aspirin require how much gram ingredients or how much granules, okay? This is for one tablet. Because 0.3 gram is, see here, in this column, here we can prepare one tablet, okay? And here we can prepare the one tablet. For preparation of one tablet, 300 mg aspirin is required. That is 0.3 gram aspirin is required. So in 0.3 gram aspirin, how much practical yield is required, okay? So again cross multiply, then x is equals to 0.364 gram gram practical yield is required for preparation of aspirin tablets. It means we can take 0.364 gram granules, aspirin granules, and fill in the dye cavity. The dye cavity is present in the tablet machine. Okay, we can fill that dye cavity by using 0.364 gram granules. Okay, and then we can punch that granules through tablet machine. Okay, then last step of the experiment. After preparation of granules, we can add sodium benzoate. Granules prepare झाल्यानंतर आपल्याला लास्टला त्याच्यामध्ये लुब्रिकंट्स ऍड करायचे. Why we can add the lubricants? To increase the flow property of that lubricant, flow property of that granules. So how much quantity of sodium benzoate we can use? See here the sodium benzoate is present 1%. Okay, so practically it is 5.19. This is the 100%. So for 1%, how much practically it is required? X is equal, then again cross multiply. 5.19 practically it contains 100%. Then for sodium benzoate 1%, how much gram is required? X is equals to 0.05 gram sodium benzoate is required for granulations. Okay, so we can add 0.05 gram sodium benzoate, 0.05 gram sodium benzoate in granules. See here, this is the aspirin granules, 5.08 grams. We can fill this aspirin granules in pouch. Then in that aspirin granules we can add fines. The quantity of the fines is, then we can add the fines. The total fines is 1.10 gram, but we have to require only 0.146 gram according to calculations. So in aspirin granules we can add 0.146 fine. Why we can add fines? To fill the any void space or any pores present in between the granules. For that purpose we can add the fines in granules and mix properly. Shake this pouch properly. Then last step, we can add lubricants, that is sodium benzoate, 0.05 grams sodium benzoate we can add to increase the flow property of granules. And after addition of sodium benzoate, again mix properly. Shake this pouch properly. So this is the granules of aspirin, and by using these granules we can prepare a tablets, and this tablet we can call as the soluble aspirin tablets. Thank you.